throughout the entirety of 2021, I've been working on a little YouTube series called TFA Mysteries, which was about exploring the unanswered questions left behind by the cancellation of Transformers Animated. Stuff like what Sari's origin would have been, or what the fourth season might have looked like. What all of that was building up to the whole year was a big hour-long video called Could Transformers Animated Ever Continue? I would have gone in and examined what specific factors were keeping the show from coming back, what needed to happen for renewal. I'd interviewed Marty Eisenberg, the show's original head writer, about what a fourth season might look like today and what it would take for a comeback. I'd interviewed individuals who spearheaded fan campaigns, both successful and unsuccessful, and I'd even talked to Randolph Hurd, the head writer of the most recent Transformers show, Cyberverse, and asked about what it would take from a Hasbro product side for the show to come back. It was going to culminate with a video montage where fans of the show, as well as crew who worked on it, talked about their memories of the show and what it meant to them. And the goal, the end goal, was to launch a handwritten letter campaign, as well as a social media hashtag trend. The show would never come back unless fans acted and made their love for the show known to Hasbro. However, while editing the video, I received news that Derek J. Wyatt, the series art director of Transformers Animated, had passed away unexpectedly. And my first reaction was shock. Just didn't really know what to do. I just paced. And after like 20 minutes, I realized I'm not gonna release that video. Because the answer to the question, could Transformers Animated ever continue, is no. For the first time, after 14 years of hoping and thinking of ways it could maybe happen, the answer is very firmly no. But now, I am done talking about YouTube. I'm done talking about what we didn't get, what we could have gotten, and now it is time to talk about what we did get, which was a fantastic show that plenty of fans and plenty of people who worked on still fondly remember. So, Transformers Community. What do you love about Transformers Animated?
Well, there's a lot of things to like about Transformers Animated.
The reason I love Transformers Animated.
The thing that I love about Transformers Animated, good characters.
These characters are what I connect to the most as far as like fiction is concerned, even like imaginary friends when I was a kid.
Megatron and Blitzwing were my two favorite characters. Megatron's so cool and intimidating, and Blitzwing so fun and ridiculous.
Each Decepticon is just so fun to watch. I can't express my love for them enough, but I just really love the way they give these interpretations to the characters.
You connect with them, you root for them, you feel for them when they go through struggles, and you cheer when they triumph.
I remember as a kid just getting the Battle Begins 2-pack of Optimus Prime and Megatron and religiously watching the DVD, basically just the first episode, over and over and over again, because I was just mesmerized.
If I could describe the show in one word, it would be magnificent.
I wanted to say thank you to Derek J. Wyatt and Marty Eisenberg for creating an amazing TV show that I loved ever since I was a kid.
It was a different take on it while respecting the franchise. In fact, as an older collector, as an older fan of Transformers, I started to notice more of the references in the show, especially some of the more obscure ones.
Transformers Animated was my childhood.
Probably one of my favorite animated things ever made, which is ironic because it's called Brandformers Branimated, you know?
The voice acting is just amazing.
I'm Brian Posehn. I played Nanosec.
Jeff Bennett here.
Hey, it's Alex Polinsky. Just found this little headmaster. Ooh! Headmaster unit!
This is John Machida Jr., aka Blur, you know, Decepticons above me, Decepticons below me, every place I look I see Decepticons!
I am a speech synthesis program built into every Mac machine. I was used as the voice of Perceptor.
David Kay. Of course, Transformers Animated, man. Yeah, what a thrill that was to do. I even have some of my toys here.
I had an incredible time working on that show. The cast was amazing. I love the storylines. I love the artwork. I'm kind of wearing that color right now. How perfectly fitting.
Obviously, I had a blast working on Transformers Animated. I got to work with some of the most amazing actors and performers on that show.
Incredible cast. I mean, we just had one of the most talented casts I think I've ever been in.
I had a blast doing it. I'm so proud to be a part of the Transformers family, this thing that's lasted for so long, and I think Transformers Animated is one of the better representations of the characters.
I love doing Transformers over the last four decades, practically. It's really been a great job for me, and I really love the people involved and the scripts and just having fun.
Transformers Animated was great.
Such a great show. And one of the first things I was able to show to my son, he's 12 now, but I showed him my episode probably about 8 years ago or so. He loved it and still thinks it's cool that I was a part of that show.
What Marty Eisenberg did with that show was so great because it didn't take itself overly seriously.
Transformers Animated actually inspired me to want to become a voice actor myself.
Transformers Animated means a lot to me because it came into my life at a very rough point. And sort of, it was something that used to help me cope with what was happening.
Seeing Optimus overcome different things in his story, strangely enough, gave me some motivation to overcome the difficulties that I was dealing with too.
I have anxiety, but I could always find comfort in Transformers Animated, and I just want to thank everyone who contributed in the making of the show.
I want to thank everyone who has worked on TF Animated.
Thank you for introducing me to a community of amazing people over the years.
And no thanks to you guys, I bought all these stupid toys.
I just want to say from the bottom of my heart,
thank you.
To the whole animated team for making the show and making my childhood wonderful.
Prowl would just like to say thank you, Marty. Thank you for being so talented and such a great writer and so understanding of our strange characters.
I'm happy I've had the opportunity and look forward to doing it a lot more in the future.
Noobs, total ownage!
It was always a party with Marty, I guess is what Ultra Magnus would say. As Nanosec says, he didn't really have a catchphrase. Yeah. See you next time if you can catch me.
And Captain Fanzone would like to say thank you as well, Marty. You are amazing. Thank you.
Transform and roll out! Or something like that.
One more time, ready? Transform and roll out! David K signing off.
You'll notice that most of those people thanked Marty. And the reason is that this was originally intended to be a big thank you for Marty Eisenberg for doing a lengthy interview with me earlier in the year. And what I couldn't have anticipated, what no one who submitted clips could have anticipated, is that this would shift in purpose and function to become a form of remembrance. I speak for myself, and I speak for much of the fandom when I say that when I think of Transformers Animated, the first person I think of is Derek Wyatt. He was, by all accounts, the absolute heart and soul of that show. And as someone who spent a whole year digging up old archive footage, old interviews, old panels, I've heard that time and time and time again from everyone who worked on the show. And all of those people talking about what they love about the show are, when it comes down to it, talking about what they love about Derek. I don't know how appropriate it is to mourn someone that I never actually met, at least not in person. You know, I don't know if Twitter conversations really counts as knowing someone, but I just feel the need to, because Derek Wyatt is someone who I've looked up to for the majority of my life. I'm just left pondering and remembering some of my favorite contributions of his to the internet. A Ben 10 fan once asked him, to whom did Ben lose his virginity? And Derek Wyatt just replied with, your mom. And I think about that like once every 6 months. That's the best response he could have given. There is a YouTube video called Derek Wyatt Just Punched Me Square in the Testicles.
Derek Wyatt just punched me square in the testicles.
It's a very good video, you know? Like, I know Derek Wyatt most likely didn't actually punch this man in the testicles, but it's just really funny to, like, imagine he did off camera, and that's what actually prompted him to say it, you know? It's one of my favorite things I found while researching. I'm really gonna miss seeing what he posts on Twitter. One of my favorite tweets of his is a photo of the Cyberverse Wild Wheel toy, and he just said, is half of this toy missing? And it's funny, because like the toy sucked, you know? It wasn't very good. I'm gonna buy that figure when I get home. That's how I'm gonna grieve. Almost every morning, I would wake up to between 20 and 50 retweets about the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Just like every morning. And I always laughed because it was like, does he just go out of his way to find Marvel things to retweet? Or does he just follow so many separate Marvel accounts that his morning scrolling ends up having like 20 to 50 MCU retweet? Another thing about him is that he had a cool mullet. Look at this photo. That's on his head. That's crazy. That's so cool. At the time I am filming this, it is not public knowledge yet. So I am hoping that no one in this neighborhood is an active TFW 2005 user with their window open, peeking out. But I've just spent the last couple days in a trance, honestly. And I just have this building anxiety that by the time I finally kind of come to terms with it and get over it, that is when the rest of the fandom will come out. And so then I'll have to spend multiple days scrolling through everyone else's mourning as well. A big dream of mine had always been to meet him or to work for him. And just kind of sad to know that that'll never happen. I just hope that he passed knowing that he made a lot of kids very, very happy, you know? Transformers Animated may be a little bit more obscure. I don't think it's gonna be at the top of any articles when this starts to make the news, but everyone my age knows Teen Titans. Everyone my age knows Scooby-Doo Mystery Incorporated, and everyone my age knows Ben 10. He inspired a lot of kids to become creators themselves and artists. A lot of those kids would go on to bug him on Twitter 10 years later. I was one of those kids. Sorry, Derek. Anyways, it's midnight between Christmas Eve and Christmas. It's below freezing. It's raining off and on. I need to get home and go to bed so that Santa Claus can come. I guess he's one with the AllSpark now. If I want to be like cringe about it and reference the Transformers. Rest in peace, Mr. Wyatt.